gentlemen, for a huge New Year's Eve party in his home in Mississippi, even invited some of his followers to join in on the festivities.
Now, who would invite these people from the W Universe to their home?
Teddy DiBiase?
I mean, that is just insanity.
And being accompanied by Camacho, from Lauren McEagle, weighing in at 205 pounds, Bonito!
Hey, Teddy DiBiase, I heard that you like to have a good time with the posse down in the parking lot and say, well, Camacho and I have never been invited to one of your little fiestecitas, homie.
What about that, say? We're not good enough to party with your posse? You gonna disrespect us, homes?
Well, then maybe, say, we're just gonna have to crash the party.
Exactly. I mean, what is this? DiBiase did not good invite gentlemen like Unico and Camacho to his parties? He just singles people out and invites who he wants to invite?
Well, Unico closed out 2011 by bringing Camacho to WWE. That was the gentleman steering the custom-made lowrider bike into the arena. These guys, Cole, have been building some serious momentum.
You know, I bought a lowrider bicycle for Christmas.
You did?
Yeah. Taking lessons over at Wave Up Progresso.
You mean a tricycle?
No, an actual lowrider bicycle. When I go over and get my teeth out of my hair cut across the border, I actually get lessons. It's true. But I want to get back to DiBiase for
maybe
a second.
You could just stay across the border.
I want to get back to DiBiase for a second. I can't believe that this guy invited these ingrates from the WWE Universe to his home for the holidays.
Yeah, it was all expenses paid as well by Ted DiBiase.
The only reason they come hang out with the guy is because he gives things away for free. I mean, think about it. You think anybody would come to this guy's party if things weren't free there?
Well, Unico and Camacho are upset that they've never been invited as DiBiase goes to the cover here on Unico. They feel disrespected for never being invited to a DiBiase posse party. As great defense being played by Ted DiBiase.
DiBiase posse, not the type of support that you're trying to give me.
Everyone is invited to the DiBiase posse party every week, even you, Cole.
I couldn't go to that thing if he gave me $1 million. Really, $1 million? I wouldn't. What redeeming quality does Ted DiBiase have? Tell me that.
I told you, Ted DiBiase is a real Southern gentleman. Ted DiBiase loves to give. He's a very giving.
What you love about Southern gentlemen? You live in New Jersey. Look at Unico just wearing DiBiase down. I love Unico. And Camacho, I tell you, that kid's impressive as well. Unico, though, I mean, he's a high flyer, but he can use the ground-based game when he wants to. And, ooh, look at this!
An example here of the ground-based game from Unico. Paul, you gave us sort of a history of the custom-made lowrider bikes last week on SmackDown.
Yeah, those bicycles were actually developed in the barrio by the Mexican immigrants because they couldn't afford the lowrider automobiles, but they didn't want to bling out their bicycles, so to speak, so they developed the lowrider bicycle.
And now, today, the lowrider bicycles are very valuable, and you're going to see this takedown here by Unico.
Very impressive. DiBiase tries to turn the tables, however.
Trying to read the expression on Camacho's face on the outside, very hard to do, as Camacho watches on.
The beard covers a lot, though.
Oh, I have the sunglasses. Ted DiBiase trying to build some momentum here to kick off 2012.
Wow, turning Unico inside out.
DiBiase quickly into the cover now, hooks the outside leg, and Unico just barely sneaks out.
Yeah, Unico showing some fight here. And I think this is going to be a great year for Unico. I can just feel it.
And DiBiase. Setting up for perhaps Dream Street there, the signature maneuver of DiBiase. Great counter by Unico back to the shoulder.
Unico's worked on that shoulder throughout this matchup. Now here, perhaps a submission maneuver trying to lock in on DiBiase here. Look at this. This is unique. Look at it.
Submission maneuver or pinning predicament.
Pinning combination. How impressive for Unico again.
Here it's your winner, Unico.
So Unico starts 2012 the way he ended 2011. Victorious here.
So impressive. And I can't wait to see what Camacho brings to the table as well in weeks to come.
DiBiase thought he was setting up Dream Street. Instead, Unico, watch this right here. We weren't sure if it was a submission or a pinning predicament. Shoulders down, Unico victorious.
I think it's made as both.
So now Unico gets on the custom lowrider bike and rides out of Friday Night SmackDown with a victory.
Go cry with your posse, DiBiase. Yeah, run.